What's up, everybody? It's Travis here from Travis.media. Today, I want to share with you 7 tips that will help you become a more confident developer. Now, back when I taught myself how to code and I landed that first job, I was the least confident developer out there. I thought that everybody on my team and everybody in the company were way smarter than me. They were finishing all of their tasks. They were building all these new features. They were understanding everything. And here I was over here struggling, taking too long on my tasks, having to Google everything, and I just lacked confidence overall. So it's been about 7 years, and I've learned a lot in that time span. So today I want to share, like I said, 7 tips for you to help you become a more confident developer. So let's get started. Number 1, learn to ask questions. Now, I could make this the whole video. That's how important this is. When I got hired at that first job, I didn't ask any questions. They would assign me a task. They would say, Travis, we need you to build this new feature. Here's some information. Do you got it? And I would say, yep, I got it. I wouldn't ask any questions because I didn't want anybody to think I was incompetent. I didn't want anybody to know that I didn't know how to do it. So I didn't ask questions. And by doing that, I suffered later. I actually had to put in double the work. I not only had to build the feature on the web app or whatever it was, but I had to go and do the research and figure out the answers to the questions I didn't ask. And again, this is because I didn't want anybody to think I was incompetent, that I knew what I was doing, that I was a good developer. But this is the dumbest thing in the world you can do. And let me share how I learned this lesson. About 3 years into me coding professionally, I got put on a project with a team of about 15 to 20 developers. One of those developers was from a different company, so I never met him before, but he asked so many questions, I thought. And it was kind of embarrassing for me, like, well, this guy is asking too much. They would assign him a task and he would ask more about it. He would challenge whether it needed to be done. He would even say stuff like, hey guys, this is difficult. This may take a couple of us to work on it. I don't even really know where to begin. And I was thinking, man, I would never ask that question and let people know that I didn't know how to do something. But that's so dumb. He asked a lot of questions. And what I learned from it is that everybody else on the team wanted to ask those questions. He was asking all the questions everybody else was scared to ask. So we were all sitting back taking notes like, man, thank you. Oh, that's a good question too. Thank you. He would ask all the questions for us. And because of this, people saw his skill because he was challenging, again, whether things really needed to be done. Should we even build this feature? Is this the way to go? And because he asked a lot of questions, he understood the scope well. So he did good work. He went over and above because he really understood what was being asked because he asked questions. Since then, I've learned the importance of doing the same. Now, there can be too many questions asked. You can be annoying, but I think many of us are far from that. We just need to learn to ask the right questions. When you get assigned a task and there's certain parts of it you don't understand, ask. Get a crystal clear picture of what needs to be done. Open your mouth. You'll not only not be looked down upon, but I think it'll help you move ahead faster in your career because you'll do good work and you'll show that you're concerned and you'll show good intentions by doing so. And I gotta stop there. I could keep going on, but learn to ask questions without thinking people are gonna look down on you for it. All right, number 2, stop resorting to Googling the answer for everything you do. And you know what I mean. Let's say you're working on a WordPress app and you get assigned some task and you have to use some WordPress hook to manipulate something. And that task gets assigned to you and you click started and then you go to your computer and you immediately type in Google how to do the thing. How do I blah, blah, blah. And Stack Overflow comes up and you try to find the answer and then you're going all over the place just trying to find the quick answer on how to do it. Now, there's nothing wrong with Stack Overflow, nothing at all wrong with it, but it's not helpful in the long run to do that as your first step in approaching coding challenges. So let's say instead I'm supposed to use some WordPress hook to manipulate something in WordPress. How about I go to the documentation and pull up that hook? And how about I read what that hook does first to see what I'm doing overall? Instead of just jumping to the answer, copy and paste, and then trying to tweak it and then getting all in the weeds, you're actually going to the source, you're learning what that hook does, and you're able to get a better picture on what needs to be done. And then maybe you can change the approach, like, hey, we don't even need that, or maybe it's much simpler or something like that because you went to the documentation. And in the long run, you're learning. Another example, let's say you're building some bigger feature. Instead of just Googling, how do I implement this thing? How about taking some notes? What needs to be done exactly? Like, what steps are helpful to get this job done? How about some diagrams? How about some pseudocode? This is part of being a developer. This is something that I did again at the beginning of my career. Everything that was asked for me, I would immediately type and try to find the answer. And I was always able to find the answer because of Stack Overflow. But years passed and I didn't really learn anything from those. And being a developer, you're supposed to have a broader skill set than just Googling the answer. Again, go to the documentation, take some notes, think like a developer, step back and say, how do I approach this? What is the right way to approach this? Let me do some pseudocode. Let me think it through. And then eventually, once you have that worked out, then go to Stack Overflow, see what other people did. But again, my point here is don't just instantly resort to Googling the answer. You'll learn more and you'll become more confident in your skills as time goes. All right, number three, remember that there are much less super talented developers out there than there are developers struggling with imposter syndrome. Most developers feel like imposters like you do. They just don't say anything, just like you don't say anything. Now, don't get me wrong, there are some great, great developers out there. You'll run across them, you'll know them instantly, but the majority of them are not. So just remember, while you think everybody out there is way better than you, they're not. Most have the same confidence problems. So let that bring you confidence. Number four, remember that all programming languages share the same concepts under the hood. Try to think more conceptually than specifically. Now let's say you're given a task and you need to go through all of the items in the database and pull out the ones that are under $3. Conceptually, you know that you need a loop. You could just loop through all the entries, pull out the ones that match that certain condition. Well, whatever language you're in, you can consult the documentation and figure out how to do that in that language. You can look up the syntax. You know you need a loop, you just need to look up how to do a loop. Doesn't matter the language. That's a great way to think as a programmer. How do I get the job done? What approach should I take? Now let me figure out how to do it in this language. And you can jump around languages that way. You can also read about better choices. Maybe this loop is better than this loop. But at the end of the day, it's still a loop. Another example, let's say that you keep writing the same type of code over and over. Well, conceptually, you know that you just need a function. And you can call the function whenever you need those series of steps executed. So again, since you've thought conceptually, you just need to figure out how to do it in that language. Don't underestimate your skills as a programmer because it's in a language or a framework that you haven't used before. You know much more than you think, just do it conceptually. All right, number five, take hard tasks. Don't be that developer that grabs all the easy stuff off the board. We don't like you, people don't like you. Grab some easy stuff, but grab some hard stuff too. Now, in your first year as a developer, you're probably gonna put in more hours than everybody else because of this. Because you're gonna grab a hard task, you're gonna struggle with it, you're gonna wrestle with it, but you still have a deadline on when that task needs to be done. So in my first job, I would grab some hard tasks and I would stay over 30 minutes, 45 minutes because I wasn't able to get this done as fast as everybody else. But in doing so, I learned a lot and I grew faster because I wasn't just grabbing the easy stuff. One of those tasks was working with Kubernetes and deploying Helm charts. I would tweak the Helm chart, deploy it, it wouldn't work. Tweak it again, deploy it, it wouldn't work. And then people would come in, hey Travis, 5 o'clock, see ya, are you leaving? Nah, I'm gonna stay another 15, 20 minutes, I'm trying to get this thing to work. 6 months later, I really understood Helm charts. I really understood Kubernetes. And that's because I did the hard tasks. Now, since you're new, don't take on all hard tasks, but don't be afraid to take them. The challenge is good for you. Number five, start a blog to explain all of the concepts that you really wish you knew. Like how SSH works, or what an X509 certificate is, how to use a certain React hook, or how .NET works under the hood. As a new developer, you're doing a lot, you're tweaking things, and you're making it work, but you really don't understand the programming concepts. Having a blog allows you to go and research that, make sense of it, and then put it out there for other people to view, read, and critique, even. So if you look at my blog, there's a lot of stuff on there that I worked on once, but it was able to go back and really process it and understand it and write my own version of it. And I use it to this day for reference. But maintaining a blog like this gives you more confidence because you're able to talk more about these programming concepts and understand what's really going on in your day-to-day tasks. And if you want to get started with the blog, it's like $2.95 a month to host it. I'll put a link below for you to use. And that leads us to number seven, which is consider starting a YouTube channel or a podcast. Now, I know you might be wondering why I have the blog. Why am I going to do this? Well, it gives you an opportunity to actually talk about the things you're writing. If you want to grow in confidence as a developer, learn to talk developer lingo. Take the blog posts that you wrote, the technical stuff that you wrote, and talk about it. Have a podcast, have a YouTube channel. Learn to talk about these things. So when you're on your next stand-up call and somebody asks your opinion, these words roll off your tongue better. And that overall will make you a more confident developer. So that's all I have. Those are 7 concepts that I think will really help you out. If you have any questions or comments on these, please leave them below. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. And I'll see you in the next video.